Ace is high. Deuce is low. Call it right and win the dough on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Thank you. Ah, thank you so much. Thank you.
You're very kind.
Bless you. Thank you and welcome to Card Sharks, the game of decisions.
As we left off last time, we have a champion who's already won over $18,000, won another match, getting ready to play the money card, so let's do it right now. Chris Maroney.
Hello, Chris. Good to see you again. Again, remind us about yourself.
Well, I'm a native Californian, a married lady, and I'm out to win a lot more money this time.
Yeah, and your husband was not with you when you won the $18,000
or so. No, now that they know I'm a winner, they're all out there so they can root me on.
Got the whole family here, right?
Right.
My spies tell me that your husband, as soon as he found out, went out and did something. What's your husband doing?
Yes, he's been out testing sports cars, test driving sports cars.
I see. Well, let's see if we can make some more money. They're pretty expensive. Let's get to the money cards. Okay, Chris. Now, the money you won in the game is yours to keep, as always. We're going to give you new money to play with, and this time you're going to bet that money. Starting on the bottom line, $200. Bet that as you will with these three cards. When you move up to the second level, we add another $200 of betting money. And again, bet it as you wish, but remember, minimum bets are $50 until you get to that top card, that big bet. And there you must bet at least half the dollars. Good luck. You're doing well. Let's keep it up. Here's $200. As in the game, a choice of two base cards. We'll start you with a queen. Pretty good card. Pretty good card. All right, Chris, $200 and a queen. What's your bet on this card?
It's lower.
All of it, remember, as in the game. It's another queen you lose. It must be lower.
Okay.
$200, lower than a queen. It's an eight. $400 now with an eight.
I think I'll bet $100 the next card is lower.
Lower. $100 lower than an eight. It's an ace.
Oh.
That's not bad. That's not a bad trade, though. You've got
not
a great
all.
Card for $100. You've got $300 now with an ace, Chris.
Okay, the whole thing that it's lower.
$300 lower than an ace. It's a four.
Oh.
$600, good card, the four. We'll move the four up to the next level and add the $200 more of betting money. Chris, you now have $800 and a four.
I think I'll bet $600 that it's higher.
$600. Higher than a four. It's a 10. You're up to $1,400, Chris, with a 10.
I'll bet $300 that it's lower.
Lower than a 10.
$300.
$300. Let's see. Oh. It ain't your money, gang. $300. Lower than a 10. It's another 8.
Oh,
see how smart she figured that out?
All right,
you're down to $1,100, but again, a great card, an ace, and still two cards to go.
The whole thing, that it's lower. All
lower.
Of it.
$1,100. Lower than an ace. It's a five. $2,200. Now, Chris, with a big bet, remember you must bet at least $1,100. You can bet more. You have $2,200. Pretty good card of five. What's your big bet?
I'm going to bet $1,700 that it's higher.
$1,700. Why the odd figure? Is that the down payment on a sports car or something, Chris? $1,700, a good big bet. $1,700, higher than a five. It's a seven, you did it. Another $3,900. Congratulations again. You're doing great. Come on down here. Good job.
Thank you very much.
You know what you're up to now? Yes, you are over $20,000, and we'll meet a new challenger right after we take time out for this.
Weekdays are great days for great action.
He's having a great time with you, Dave. We're going to have a great contest.
Great excitement.
Isn't that great?
Doesn't that put us in a great light here?
I've been great. I'm thrilled to be here.
Great fun.
All-time great.
Great matchups.
Great.
Great.
Great. Great. Great.
It's a great way to spend the day.
Isn't that a great deal?
Great.
Great.
Greater.
Greatest.
Very nice indeed.
It's great. You'll see.
Daytime Buzz. It's great. Today, starting at 10, only on Buzzer. Let's play. Like vintage game shows on TV? Then you'll love them online. It's the all-new BuzzerPlay.com. Find times for your favorite shows, stream videos, and see what's trending now and in 1975. And stay connected with our fan newsletter, BuzzerPlay.com. Let's play online.
Chris, again, our congratulations. What were you saying about this is getting habit for me?
Yes, it is. Very.
It's a nice habit, isn't it?
Yes.
You ready to be a new challenger?
I sure am.
All right, then. Let's open the board and get to the cards. Get the cards set for the game there. Janice and Ann, if you will, start loading in the cards. And while they're doing that, we'll meet our new challenger on Card Sharks. Hello, Dick Shepard.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Well, nice to have a nice group out there wishing you well. Tell us about yourself, sir.
Well, I'm originally from England, and I moved over here about 2 years ago, and I'm a disco DJ.
You're in a disco? You're a DJ?
Right. I work in a major chain here in Southern California.
That sounds like very interesting work.
It's fun.
How do they like your English accent?
They really like it. I don't just spin, I talk between the records and put on a little bit of a party. So we have a good time.
That sounds good. I have found that people with an English accent can say the most outrageous things, and it sounds good.
Well, thank you.
Nice to have you here, Dick. Good luck in the match. Each player has their own deck of 52 playing cards, and they're shuffled and cut before we go on the air. And the red cards on top will be played by Chris, our champion. The lower cards, the blue cards, will be played by our challenger, Dick. Now, players, the object of the game is to work your way across the board, predicting whether each of these cards is higher or lower than the one that precedes it. Before you can begin calling high-low on the cards, you have to first answer a high-low toss-up question. And they're all based on a poll of 100 people, and they test your ability to judge human nature. My little G2T2 is out here, and we'll start with a question to you, Chris. We polled 100 husbands across the country and asked them, in today's marriages, who is more likely to stray, the husband or the wife? How many husbands said the husband is more likely to stray?
Oh, that always seems like that's more prevalent. I'd say they would say 60.
60?
Mm-hmm.
She says that 60 out of 100 husbands say the husband is more likely to stray. Dick?
Well, I think today's society is pretty liberal, but there's still more... there's still more pressure on the man, I think, to stray. So I'll have to go just a little bit higher.
You say even higher than that?
Right.
Well, if it is higher, Dick, you'll go to the board first. If not, it'll be Chris. The actual number of husbands who think the husband is more likely to stray is... 81, Dick, it's higher. You got it. Yeah. All right, Dick, we'll take a look at your base card for this game. You won the high-low toss-up question. You have the right to change it if you'd like. You have a 7. Do you want that?
No way. No, I'd like to change it.
Here's the next card off the top of your deck. You must play this. It is an 8. Ooh. All right, Dick, you've got to play it. Is this card higher or lower than an 8?
Lower. I think I'll go lower. Thank you.
Was that your considered opinion or the last voice you heard, Dick?
It was both.
You say lower than an 8. Remember, if it's another 8 you lose, it must be lower than an 8. It is a 2. Now, Dick, you can freeze at any time or you can continue, but if you make a mistake, you lose all the cards back to your base card, and Chris gets a free chance. What's it going to be?
I'll wait for that voice. Oh, definitely higher.
You're going to continue higher than a 2. It is a 3. Ooh.
I've got to go on, Jim. I've got to go on. One more time, I'll go higher.
Higher than a 3. It's a 4. Look at that. 2, 3, 4.
Higher, without a doubt. Higher.
You're going to go.
Yeah, higher.
If this is higher than a 4, you've won the first game in the match. For the first game in our best 2 out of 3 match, higher than a 4. It's a 9. He did it.
Thank you.
Just like that. Very nicely done, Dick.
Thank you.
Pressure's on, Chris. Can she make a comeback? We'll find out in a moment. Right now, we're going to take time out for a message from our sponsors. Please watch. Clear the board, Janice, please.
Raver.
Hello there.
Dawson.
Survey said.
The Sass.
I don't mind your shedding tears of joy, but you're crying on my new suit.
The Class.
You gonna watch the telly tonight, are you?
The Long Mic.
That is absolutely correct.
The Longer Kiss.
I've gotten aroused.
Two originals, 2 hours.
The lunatics have taken over the asylum, so.
Match Game and Family Feud together again, today at 10, only on Buzzer.
You said it very well.
Let's play.
Dick Shepard, our challenger with one game and $100, and Chris Maroney, the champion, has her pressure on now. She needs two in a row if she wants to get back to the money card. Janice, if you will, deal out the cards, same two decks of cards, and these are the next cards right off the top of the deck. Dick, we start with a question to you. We asked 100 women who have been married over 25 years. Is your husband still as romantic as he was when you were a bride? How many women said yes?
If they've been married over 25 years, I think to stay together, there must be a lot of romance in the marriage. So I'll say 55, says their husband, still as romantic.
Not too much agreement with the audience there. He says 55 out of 100 say that still as romantic as when they were first married. Chris, higher or lower?
Well, my parents and my in-laws have both been married over that, and they're very romantic, but I think they're a little bit more the exception, so I'll say lower.
You say lower. Mm-hmm. And I'll find out, as you do, the actual number of women married over 25 years whose husband is still as romantic is 50. It is just a little lower, right up the middle. Yeah. I figure the rest of them figured if you stay up over 10 o'clock, that's being romantic there. All right, Chris, we'll take a look at your base card for this game. You have a 10.
I think I'm going to try and change that.
Changing it to a 2. Good change.
Let's go higher.
Higher than a 2. It's a queen, very much higher.
Let's keep going and go lower this time.
Lower than a queen. It's a 9.
I think I'll freeze right there.
You'll freeze it right there. So Chris needs just 2 cards, and you've kept Dick away from his cards. Question to you this time, Chris. Okay. We took a poll of 100 women at a supermarket in Burbank, California, and asked them, if someone with only one item asked to get in line ahead of you, would you let him in? How many women said they would not let someone ahead of them in line?
Oh, I can't imagine that. 15.
15 say no, they wouldn't let that person with one item ahead of them. Dick, higher or lower?
I'll go lower because... Yeah, I'll go lower. You're... I just got a good feeling about it.
All right, you say lower. The actual number of women who would not let someone in line ahead of them is 2. Very much lower, Dick. Wow. That is a surprise. Isn't that nice how polite people are? We'll take a look at this. A 3.
It's a good card, Jim. I'll keep it. I'll keep it. And I'll go higher.
Higher than a 3. It's a jack.
All right. One more, and let's try going a little bit lower.
Lower than a jack. It's a 4.
After the last time, I've got to keep going. I'm going to say it's going to be higher.
Higher than a 4. He's risking both of those cards, and this one, it's a 9. Got away with it.
I'll freeze.
You'll freeze. Needing just 1 card. Chris's 2. Question to you this time, Dick. We took a confidential poll of 100 New York cab drivers and asked them, now be honest, have you ever dented a parked car and driven away without telling anyone? How many cab drivers admitted they had? 90, said someone.
120. No, I would say they're pretty careful. They get into... accidents, but not too many with parked cars. I'd say maybe 40 have.
40? Chris, what do you think, higher or lower?
Oh, I've never been in New York, but from what I hear, I think it'd be higher.
You say higher than that. The actual number of cab drivers who confess they've dented a car but not told anyone is 23. It's not higher, Dick. Yeah. Okay. All right, Dick, we're looking at a 9. Do you want it?
No, I'm going to change it. I'll definitely change it.
Very important change for Dick. It is a 4.
Oh, good card. Jim, it's just got to be higher.
Higher. If this is higher than a 4, we have a new champion on Card Sharks. Higher than a 4, it's a queen. He did it. Dick Shepard. Congratulations, Dick. That's nice. Congratulations, sir. Fine win. Chris Maroney, you are leaving us in cash $22,200. You're a fine gentleman. Thank you, Chris. Congratulations. Dick, come on down here. Congratulations again.
Thank you very much, Jim.
I hope you can do as well as Chris.
Well, I certainly hope so. $22,000 sounds good.
It does. We'll find out right after we take time out for this commercial message. That would be nice.
The 50s were cool. The 60s were groovy. The 70s were happening. And the 80s? Well, they're just like the 50s, 60s, and 70s. Experience it all. The games, the fashion, the prizes. Ride the Buzzer Time Machine. Saturday starting at 8, only on Buzzer. Let's play.
Yeah, we're back with our new champion, Dick Shepherd. And Dick, some of the young ladies during the commercial were asking if you were single. They were delighted to find out you are. If you make a lot of money now, you're going to be a lot more attractive to them, Dick.
I certainly hope
so. So let's get to the money cards. There we go. Hop on up there. And, Dick, you know how we do it. You've got $200 for winning the game, yours to keep. Now we've got some brand new cards, all shuffled and cut, if you will. $200 on the lower cards there. Bet them as you wish. When you move up to the next level, another $200 of betting money. And again, three more cards to bet with. $50 minimum bets till that top card, that big bet. There you must bet at least half the money. Good luck, right, Dick. Let's do well. $200.
Okay.
And your first base card, which is a two. That's the way to start.
Great.
All right.
That's a great card, Jim. I'll keep it and I'll put all the $200 on it and say higher.
Good. Yeah. Gotta go with a card like that. $200 higher than a two. It's a queen. Very much higher. You've got $400. Dick.
Okay, I'll put $300 on and I'll go lower.
Lower than a queen. $300 lower. Oh no, it's an ace.
Oh.
Wow. But you've got an ace and $100, and you've still got five cards to go, so you can build it up, Dick.
Right, let's put the whole $100 on and go lower.
$100 lower than the ace. Oh, no! And that's all right. You're not out of it. You've only busted on this level. You've got the ace. We've got that other $200 of betting money. Let's give Dick that $200 right now with an ace.
I've had two aces. I'm sure I can get a third, so I'll put the whole $200 on and go lower.
All right. It can happen, but let's hope not. Lower. $200. It's a jack. Yeah. All right. $400 now, Dick.
I'll put $300 on and go lower.
$300 lower than the jack. It's a three, very much lower. Now they're moving for you.
All $700 on and go higher.
$700 higher than a three. It's a five. You build it up very well, considering two busts. You've got $1,400 and a five. Now, Dick, moving up to the big bet, you must bet at least $700. You can bet more.
Okay. A five's not a great card, so I'm going to put, let's put $800 on it and go higher.
$800. Higher than a five. For an $800 bet, you did it! Dick. That's a nice comeback. Congratulations. Come on over here with me. That's great. Let me slide over here with you. Good comeback.
Thank you very much, Jim.
With two busts to wind up with $2,200, that's a nice comeback.
Well, I'm still chasing the former champion, $22,000.
That's right. You got a way to go on that, but you're up to $2,400, and you're here as our champion. Dick, come on out of the way here before the mechanics get to you. Why don't you slide up here now, if you will. And as Dick gets comfortable, ladies, we'll get set up for the next game. Janice with two brand new decks of cards. And we'll welcome our next challenger on Card Sharks. Hello, Khaki Gray. Is it Khaki? That's an unusual name.
Well, it's really Catherine.
Catherine.
But everybody calls me Khaki.
Why do they call you Khaki?
Because that's what my daddy wanted to name me.
Oh. Oh. Dick, would you talk with your accent?
What do you want me to say?
Oh, I'm sorry. I just wanted to find out if you were English, too. Where are you from, Khaki?
I'm Bluff, Arkansas.
Good. Tell us more about yourself.
Well, I used to be a dental assistant, and I was married then. And then I got a divorce and tried to live on $72 a week and decided I either had to go husband hunting or go back to school. So I went back to school, and I'm starting dental school in September. Now I'm going to be the dentist.
All right. Good for you, Khaki. Nice to have you here. You'll play the lower cards, the blue cards. Dick plays the upper cards, the red cards, and the first question to Dick. We asked 100 men in California, when you see a good-looking woman walking by, what do you look for at first, her face or her figure? How many men said they usually notice her figure first?
Well, we have an expression in England, that's a leg man, and I think a lot of California men do look at the figure first.
How many?
I'll say, 65.
65. Higher or lower, Khaki?
Oh, I think it's higher because
you say higher.
Faces are hidden behind sunglasses.
The actual number of men who first look at a girl's figure is 56. It's not higher. Dick. Dick, we'll look at that base card. You have an 8. Do you want it?
No, thank you, Jim. I'd like to change it.
And the next card is a 10.
That's
play that one and
good
call
card.
This.
I'll go lower, please.
Lower than a 10. It is a 9.
Okay, I'll take a chance, and I'll say it's lower again.
Lower than a 9. It is a jack, and it's not lower. And let's quickly get to Khaki's base card. You have to play a jack. Call this one, Khaki.
Lower.
Lower than a jack. It is an ace. It is not lower. Both players busted. We'll fill in the spaces, and while Janice is doing that, we'll take time out for this commercial message.
Up next, contestants try to match wits with insane celebrities while Gene Rayburn tries to control it all on a buzzer double play of Match Game. Next, stay tuned.
And Dick and Khaki and the rest of our United Nations will be back next time on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
One of our polling groups will receive Whirlpool's electric range with self-cleaning oven, lift-up spill guard top, and full-width black glass panoramic door furnished by Whirlpool Corporation. And some of our contestants will receive a True Test Waffle Baker and Grill from True Value Hardware Stores, who combine value and personal service in over 5,000 locations nationwide, and a gift set from new improved Breck Shampoo. Now you can see, feel, and smell what new improved Breck Shampoo does for your hair, and the selection of Tenti products, the great new building set from Hasbro. With Tenti, it's a snap to be a better builder. And from West Clocks, the smartly styled, compact, Big Ben, solid-state LED, digital AM-FM, instant-on clock radio. West Clocks looks ahead in time, a Tally Industries company. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.